Welcome back, guys, to the next adventure on Starfox Adventures. Oh my god, I've messed up the start again, but who cares? I've already done a bit of the traveling. Tricky's asleep here as we run circles around him and he doesn't wake up with catching some Z's, that's for sure. As we head into Thorntail Hollow, so we can get straight to the action, whatever action is there, or what will we see when we get there? I'm expecting some kind of cutscene to... that makes it obvious. With a queen there, that makes it 100% obvious that cutscenes are the name of the game.
Fox, something is not right. The walled city has not yet returned to the planet. My husband is still stuck up there. You did return all of the spellstones.
Of course, but wait. The spirits, they must have something to do with it.
You're right. Without all the spirits, the magic cannot be channeled back into the planet.
Your boss said to return to the walled city. There must be a shrine we've yet to find.
Okay, the walled city it is. Off we go to space. I really thought we wouldn't be going to space again. I really thought that was it. We were done and done with space. It was all about Dinosaur Planet from now on, but up we go again. To take part in some shooting trials. Of course, there were two gigantic walled sections walled off in the walled city that we never got to enter. I just thought they were just there for no reason, for atmosphere of a gigantic walled city, but obviously it was for later on. I just thought it was design. Whatever. Here we go up into our space. So, the walled city it is.
Hurry, Fox! There must be another Krazoa shrine hidden within the walled city. When you land, go directly to the King Earthwalker. He should be able to tell you where to start looking. Peppy out!
Peppy out. That's the 7 gold rings one, if I'm correct, as he says it's right as I say that. So it's time to get flying. It's not exactly going to be hard to hit the total we need. 7 gold rings was never a hard task, let's put it that way. I really should look for the gold ring. There he is. The 7 is still a total that could mess up. Did I actually shoot it to collect that one? I'm not sure what happened there. Boost through. Break. Look at the expert flying skills. They're coming back to me. Everything that I've learned in the past. As I crash into a billion walls. Pride comes before a fall, they say, and that was very much a case there. Picking up some more bombs and crashing into things after saying I was good. Ooh, could I have got blue lasers? Can you get blue lasers in this game? We've only managed to get, like, a certain amount up to now. So I wonder about that. Oh, okay. Pretty use the bomb to blow up the mines, get the last gold ring, and we're through! Was that all 10 with the crashing and the destruction as we went along there? All 10, top of the leaderboard. That's how we do things. Just don't concentrate on it. Just go by autopilot. Literally just let... feel it, not think it. Alright then, so all the way around to Triggy's dad at the bottom of the temple. A little bit of a walk, but it won't be hard. But we got to see what puzzles or whatnot we're going to be getting here, plus the trial itself. What will the trial entail? Or maybe we're not looking for Tricky's dad, considering him and the other Earthwalkers are just there.
Fox, on behalf of Dinosaur Planet, I thank you for returning the spellstones to their rightful place.
For what good it did? If you didn't notice, you're still stuck up here in this floating rock.
By removing the spellstones, Scales caused our planet to tear apart. Returning the stones has stopped the flow of magic energy, but only by the power of the Krazoa spirits will the floating lands return.
Seems like we both have our reasons for finding the last of the spirits. The Queen said I could find one here in the city. So where is it?
The spirit will be revealed once both the sun and moon stones are returned to the temple.
Okay then. So, from here, it's either right or left into the walled city segments. I'm heading this way first for no apparent reason. Maybe I should head the other way first. I don't know. I guess the red side is the sun side. Does it matter if it's night or day currently? Is it going to be some kind of puzzle like that? Or am I just completely overthinking things that I would do as a game developer? What's up, sir?
Your goal may seem close, but the answer is not always so clear.
Well, okay, that was a bit of an obscure sentence yourself, sir. So, we have blocks, we have suns, and I guess, judging by the... I guess it's a block puzzle. Moving them onto the suns or some such. But I guess we can only make a certain amount of moves. I mean, this one has to go over there in the first place, so... Because, of course, I can't pull it out. I have to push. I could push this one straight over there. Or I could get that one in there. I don't exactly know what's going on here, but... That one will go straight over there, and that one will go off here and into there. Okay. I'm just going to trust my instincts, trust my intuition. Get it done. That wasn't hard. Thought these puzzles were going to be like something devious or monstrous or some such. Right then. So that opened up over in this temple thing. Is there anything behind it? Not a thing. Not a sausage. Hello, Tricky. Apart from you. You, me, and the world. But there's no steps to climb up here, so how on earth am I supposed to, A button prompt. It's a stairlift. For once, George has made us not use a ladder. So what are we doing here, exactly? Well, there's some portal off in the distance, but... Ooh. I zoomed slightly, and something happened there. Ow. Okay, I wasn't expecting that to happen. I seem to have opened up the temple underneath me. What puzzles will it contain? We'll never know until we get in there and have a look and get hit by bats. And we need the freezy thing. Die, bats, die. Okay, we have some blocks. They look like they need to be pushed in, but maybe not at the same time.
Wait for me.
Actually, let's check the back of the blocks. Do they have any symbols or something? They do have symbols. This one has a moon symbol. Ah, so I get you. That actually does go in there. See, I'm getting good at these puzzles, I am. That one I'll have to go to the side slightly for a second. As we pull the moon into position to push it into the edge. There we go. And in we go, so to say. Ah, no, they have to go facing frontwards. Okay. I'd have thought that it was just the marker itself has to go in, but obviously not. It doesn't matter that it's sun and moon. It has to be facing forward. Fox with his crazy strength skills. Tricky's just fallen asleep again. He doesn't seem to want to be an active participant of anything lately. In fact, Tricky's skills have been used less and less and less. Well, there's a slam pad. Some form of maze. And a switch, which we cannot access. So let's get the slam going. As he keeps missing the menu. Find out what's going on. Do we just have to get through in time? What was that switch for then? Our switch is closed. What's going on? Don't have no clue what that switch was for, but... Ah! Barriers! We have to find switches close the barriers. And we need to use multiple skills, so that's going to be an annoying thing. I was going to say something bad there. Might we need Tricky as well, considering the fact that Tricky's food is bouncing around the place. Is that the switch for that one? Yes. It's like, oh yeah, here we go. Oh, don't want to do that. And that's the last barrier, I think. It's like a puzzles within puzzles. And Tricky's food's bouncing around, though. You know something's going on, don't you? Right then. Time to open up the portal door. And encounter even more puzzles, as you do. So we've got to hit every switch. I'm guessing there'll be one down? No. Ah, no, wait a second. Look at this first. Are we going sunset to sunrise or sunrise to sunset? That's what I want to know. See, I'd go from that to... Or is that moon, sunrise, sun? I'm not sure. Is there anything to indicate what we're doing? No, nothing at all. Oh, I even missed. They seem to be different stages of the sun, let's put it that way. Now that is not the right one, as it just instantly went away. And I'm trying to hit that and I'm missing. Okay, that is the first step. Is that the second one? Missed it. Missed it. Had to speed up, didn't it? I'd imagine it'd be that one next, strangely enough. Apart from the fact that I cannot hit it, which has got me with my slightly irritated at myself voice going now. Yeah, that worked. Okay, is that one next then? Oh, I missed. I got it in, but I missed. And I've run out of energy. Which is not a clever thing to do. Quick, I've got a puzzle to solve. Oh, I've got to get the target right. It's about here. The sensitivity of the stick doing me in again. No, my thumb is twitching and I can't keep it still, so it's distracting my shooting timing. Okay, now we got flames and an invisible leap of faithy platform. And the sunstone right in the center. Right, so that's one temple down, one more to go. This is a sunstone. Place it underneath the temple to reveal the Krazoa shrine. And hightail it back out to the moon temple. So obviously these same things are going to go on there. Some kind of puzzle underground. A block puzzle maybe as well outside. Maybe it's, I mean, they looked the same setup when the cutscene that showed them both was around. I mean, it's got the same temple on either side, the same pyramid, you could say. So it's about finding out what to do underneath. Ah, you easy block puzzle, you. I kind of figured you out straight off the bat. Because, of course, you couldn't hit the meal all in at the exact angles anyway. You had to bounce them off other ones. And if you hit the edge, then you're pretty much screwed. Because as soon as one of them goes on the edge, you would have been done in. You wouldn't have been able to go any more moves. It would just go constantly around the edge because you can't pull it towards you. It's a push puzzle.
Where the walls fade, time is your only enemy.
Okay, where the walls fade, time is my only enemy. That must mean... Well, that trial was underground, I guess, with the switches. But we do have another block puzzle. So, same rules apply. If I hit the outside edge, I can only hit one, and then I'm screwed for the rest of them. So the question is, where to go first? Because that one seems to be the problematic one. Oop. I love how the camera turned itself around. That's very... friendly of it, or should I say, highly annoying. Where to first? I don't know how to get a block to here. I'm looking at this puzzle and I honestly don't know how to get a block to that position. We can go straight across to that one, and then that one can go across to that one. That one can go nowhere then. Right, that's useless. That one can go against the wall and go to that one, which will then lance that one up there. No. What is the solution for this one? The first one was easy. This one seems a bit more difficult. Push that one over to there, so that one can go against there. Then that one would come against there, which wouldn't do anything, because it would just fly across. And then we'd be on the outside edge. We could bring it around to there, but that doesn't get anything to there. That's the problem. This is the problem one. Right. Right. No, I still have no clue. I can look at everything that I can do here, and it's just confusing. So, I mean, we can push that one into there. Maybe if I start doing, I might be able to figure it out rather than just mulling over it. Because you guys can probably see a solution. It's a bit different for me. So that's just go nowhere then. That one's... That's screwed it. That's not how we do it. Because all I can do is go against there, and then that's it. Can't do anything. Oh! And he disappeared. Obviously, that is the wrong moves I've done. So... Ooh! Ooh! I got it! This over there. We're leaving that one there because we can push this one against that block. Push it over against that block. Push it over against that block. And hit the remaining thing. Lovely! That was a nice puzzle. I enjoyed that. No simple answer. And I guess it's the same routine for this place. Up we go. That block puzzle was cool. I like that quite a bit. I wonder how many of you guys solved that from first sight. Right, so we use the visor. Zoom in. Blind ourselves in the moonlight. Because it's very idiotic to just directly look at a source of light. Even though, of course, moonlight isn't a direct source of light, it is the reflection of the sun on the moon. Whatever, let's not get into the science of it all. Head down to some more puzzles. Now, will it have the same layout of puzzles, or a different one? Right. I have to question... Well, I was about to say, I have to question what was difficult about this. And it seems that there are floorboards that are not there. Oh, if you stand still for too... Maybe it is. Stand still for too long, you fool. You have to keep moving around. Yes, it is stand still for too long and you fall. That is tested, despite the fact that I wasn't actually trying to test it. That was just me being a moron. Right, so that goes up. We wait for that one to come down. And then we move between the four platforms that are over there. And we wait. And we wait. And we move. And we move so slowly. Zigzagging, zigzag, zigzag. Lovely. Easy to do. Did that just shut behind me or something? No, it's just the odd platform way. Another smash pad. And we have a puzzle with invisible walls. It's an invisible wall mazy thing. Right. Who could have guessed it was round this way? Not me, that's for sure. all the way around here. Let's just hurry up and try to get it done as fast as possible. No, we're going in rounds. We only have a little bit of time, but we made it. No problem. Invisible maze. Check. Completed. And defeated. And now we move on to the cycles of the moon, which are a lot easier to figure out, so to say. We're going from crescent to full. Crescent to full. We might want to get some more energy, which is not over there. So let's just line up, ready for the shot. Ready for the shot. Come on. It'd be nice to get them all in one little barrage of shots there, but it's not going to be. Let's line up, get ready. Fire. That one was a lot easier. That was a lot of an easier thing. The cycles of the moon are obvious after all. Cycles of the sun, not so much. I guess lines don't really tell much of a story. This is the moonstone. Place it underneath the temple to reveal the Krazoa shrine. We now have both stones. So all that's left is to head out and place them. As we dodge the flames of doom. Hopefully we don't have to take an invisible maze back, because that would be kind of annoying. That would be very annoying indeed. Too far away for the HPs. And so, guys, I'm going to leave you be this episode, as there is no invisible maze. Lovely, lovely. And we'll come back next time for the Krazoa Shrine Trial and whatever lies within. Are these platforms going to disappear now? No, they're not. They're solid now. So, guys, tune in next time, and I will see you around. Cheers for watching.